Hi, it's Tom again. I'm in the display and trial garden right outside the greenhouse. As you can see, a beautiful display and trial garden. And what I want to show you is some of the basic structure of shoots. Now, remember that in the lecture, or you'll read shortly in the lecture, that a shoot is made up of a central axis called a stem. So I'm looking here at what I would call the central axis of a shoot. So that's just the main part. And the central axis or stem has a repeating structure that's quite distinct and important to remember about shoots. That is, they have nodes. And so here's, I'm pointing to one node, another node, another node, another node. And I'll just define a node as a place where something happens on the shoot. That's vague, I know, but just bear with me a minute. And then between the nodes is a section called an internode. So we have two nodes and an internode. What do I mean by things that happen at a node? Well, the node is the place on the stem where you can have a leaf attached, or you can have an inflorescence. An inflorescence is a name for a single flower or a group of flowers. It's the flowering structure of the plant. Or you can have a branch form. Let's find a branch over here. Here we go. Let's see if we can find my finger. There we are. So I don't know if you can see down here in here very well. I think maybe you can. We have a central axis, a stem, and what's happening here? Well, we have a leaf attached to the node and also a branch coming off the main stem. So we're seeing a couple of examples of things that can happen from nodes. Nodes are the places on the central axis of the shoot, the stem, where things happen.